things related to employment, etc. So I remember those times, and I really resonated with, even though I was not Buddhist at that moment, resonated with the peaceful path. So I had the opportunity, if I wanted to, been involved in many different groups, and I always gravitated towards those groups that were espousing nonviolence and making a difference in that way. And that's what I would encourage.
I had a pretty old job too, and I remember those days. I strongly believe, and that's one reason why I chose Buddhism, that I believe that peace begins with within. It's very, very difficult to change other people. So it's up to us as Buddhists to be an example, to be peaceful ourselves. And I truly promote local, knowing your neighbors, being tolerant of others. And I think these are all things that Buddhism promotes. So my sense is that it really begins here, and then it works out on people you might or might not be able to influence that way.
My suggestion is, it's very basic, just contemplating on cause and effect. So that is a very fundamental teaching in Buddhism today. So cause and effect, okay. There are a lot of conflicts, right, of course, and we have to take a deeper look on what caused the conflicts, right? And then go to see what's happening. Maybe it's just a difference between backgrounds, different between, like educational backgrounds, different between cultural behaviors. So then you can realize that there is just something that is not really crucial to, I don't know how to say that, but if we know the cause and effect, and we started to know the reason why we have different point of view, we are the human beings are always to, pursuing the goodness, right? But by pursuing the goodness, we create conflicts because there are different interests of different each person. By contemplating cause and effect, we know the intention of others, and we started to understand why he or she behaves like this. And that creates compassion, that creates understanding. I think that understanding is very important. So just like, for example, I have another sister nun, just called sister nun, I don't know how to call that in Christians, okay? Sister nun working with me. And she's from Malaysia, I'm from Taiwan, even though we speak in the same Mandarin Chinese. But there are different usage of it. And so I kind of like, when I was cooking, I said that I was cooking a dish, and she misunderstood me that she doesn't have to cook rice, something like that. And there's no rice for us than that meal. And if I don't understand the cause, that we have different usage of the language, the same language, then I might get pissed off, right? Okay, right. There's no rice. Rice is very important, Yeah. So by understanding the cause and effect, I think that creates understanding, and it creates loving kindness and compassion to each other. And even we have conflicts, but it will be through understanding we can have space, we can have tolerance, right? And then there will be no further arguments, or further, some conflicts will be, getting high, and then verbal, and then it creates a physical, and then, a group of people, something like that. So it won't elevate to that level. Okay, so by realizing cause and effect, we know we have mutual understanding, and we create compassion. That's my method.
I concur with the rest of them. I think respect and loving kindness are very important. That's the clear. Loving kindness not only to your friend or family, it's also towards your enemy, adversary, of any kind. You come to understand them, you respect them, their opinion, and so on. I was surprised that we have 9/11. The Buddhist group was invited. That next morning to the church in New York, and they have other religious group, they thought they're too peaceful, maybe. The Buddhist teaching also, called Patimokkha. You heard of the three main message of why do bad deed, do the good deed, and purify your mind. That's the higher voice. But there are two more messages there. First, he said, tolerance is the key. Tolerance, kanti. Tolerance is the key for your practice. And nirvana is your goal. Dhamma, ultimate peace, and happiness. And then he said, one who harm others is not a priest. And one who kill others is not a monk. Something like that. And then he went on to the last part. One, he give you guideline how to do it. He give you principle first, and then he give you the main message of why you're valued to do it in your body. Then he went on to how do you do it. He said, not to harm others physically, and then second, not to harm others verbally, and third, to moderate consumption. And fourth, to respect and observe disciplinary rules for monks 27 pieces in our tradition. You probably have more than 40 now. And then he said, the next one is to live in a secluded area to train your mind, practice your mind towards the environment. And that's the method he gave you. So also, you can apply this to guideline like this, and I sum it up as a peacemaker. Peacemaker is to tolerate others. And I gave this talk to, we have a United Nations, Dr. Ockman used to have that once a year, commemorate October 24th of each year, UN Day, now people see less importance. And we have a United Nations Society here in San Luis representing towards the whole world. They meet once every 2 months, and I was there more than 3 years. And you know, she asked me to address this issue about world peace, and I pulled this up as a peacemaker, what it should be like. And everyone can be a peacemaker, like everyone here. That Buddhism stressed the fact that peace starts here in your mind individually. And then you can spread it out, and then everyone, especially the leader, has to be peaceful, and otherwise they can create war easily. Like you see the North Korea, so, and you got someone who responded, then it could be a larger argument and so on. So very important, and that's come to the point about volition is karma. If you have bad intention, volition is intention, basically the same. Volition, what is it? Karma is action point. So volition is karma, or intention is karma. Having will or have intention, you will respond or act or think or speak according to your will. So very important. So if you commit any karma, it starts here in your mind. So tolerance is the message, and loving kindness is the answer how to do it.